Dr. Mahajan, here's the another key question that a lot of people are asking. I've had COVID. I've recovered from COVID. Wasn't a very serious attack. How long after I have recovered from COVID should I have my vaccine? If I haven't been vaccinated yet, or if I've had one shot, when should I have my second shot? What should that waiting period be? I can't tell you how many people are asking that question.
Yeah, no. That's a very valid, very relevant question, especially today, when everyone, you know, that vaccine hesitancy has been overcome. So the answer is pretty clear. The US CDC says that you wait for 90 days after recovery from COVID for getting your jab. So it may be the first jab or it may be the second jab. If you get, you know, COVID after your first jab, then your second jab should be after 90 days from the day of recovery. And if it's you haven't had a jab, then also it is 90 days. Because the reason is very clear that you do develop antibodies which protect you from infection after getting a COVID infection. And this definitely lasts till 90 days. In fact, it can last for 6 months and even longer. But they say wait 90 days, you are protected during this time, you won't get COVID again, and get your jab at 90 days. And this is the US CDC recommendation. I also recommend the same because there's logic behind it. And there are, of course, as many people you ask, someone will say 2 weeks, someone's going to say 4 weeks. But it's very clear that you will be protected for those 3 months. Don't worry about it. Get your jab at 90 days. Irrespective of what jab it is.
90 days after you recover. That's really interesting what you're saying. I've been having this argument with many people, including with my brother, who said, I'm going to go. He just recovered. He said, I'm going to go and get a vaccine after a month. I said, I think you have to wait 3 months. So you're saying 3 months is the amount that you should wait.
Absolutely.
The other question, which again, many people are asking, Avanita has this question, what should be the maximum time gap between those two jabs? It's another question that a lot of people, 4 weeks, 6 weeks, 8 weeks, you know.
So that question is really being asked in the context of the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine. The others, it's fixed, you know, it's 4 weeks for Covaxin, the vaccine from Bharat Biotech. There's no doubt there. For Covishield, the vaccine from Serum Institute, the name that is there in India, you know, when they ran the trials, they actually vaccinated people at various intervals. And what is seen is that as you increase the interval, the effect, the efficacy of the vaccine is better if the second jab is given later. Now, the Indian government has mandated that it be given between 6 to 8 weeks. The UK government has said that we will give it at 3 months. And it seems at 12 weeks, the efficacy of the vaccine is higher than if it is given at 4 weeks, 6 weeks or 8 weeks. But today, the government mandates 6 to 8 weeks. All of us healthcare workers and frontline workers who got Covishield in the beginning, since we were amongst the, you know, privileged lot to get it early, we got our second shot at 4 weeks. But the time now, as per the Indian government, is 6 to 8 weeks. The ideal, it would seem, is 12 weeks.
Okay, but it's based on one study, right? So if somebody is getting a second vaccine, 4 weeks, 6 weeks, 7 weeks, it's not that it's bad. It's not that it hurts you or it may have slightly lower efficacy on the basis of some studies.
Yes, right. And more importantly, you have to also remember that during that interim 3 months, your immunity levels keep falling down. So you have to be extra careful. Not that after the second jab, you don't have to follow COVID-appropriate behavior. Your mask should be there all the time, even later, because even those who've been fully vaccinated have developed the infection. So we have to differentiate between infection and disease. You may get the infection, but you get very mild or asymptomatic disease if you're fully vaccinated, irrespective of what vaccine you've had. The experience around the world is that a very small percentage, maybe 3%, 5% may need to go to hospital. But in that interim 3 months that you're waiting, one, you know, you don't know if there's a vaccine shortage. you may have a problem getting the vaccine.
That's a concern. That's a concern. That's exactly why I'm asking. That's what people are saying.
I would like to add something to this.
Yeah.
What Dr. Mahajan is saying is absolutely correct, 100% correct, and I endorse it. But here I would like to just add one more thing, that I am still of the view that 6 to 8 weeks is better than waiting for 12 weeks. Because after 6 to 8 weeks, after 6 weeks, the efficacy improves exactly, but the improvement is very small. So in the current scenario where there's a pandemic raging and the chances of getting infected are high, and well, all of us are very, or people are very scared that we may not get infected in this interim period, I recommend, as per the Government of India and as per ICMR guidelines, that 6 to 8 weeks, take a shot in 6 to 8 weeks. Don't wait for 8 to 12 weeks. Though what Dr. Mahajan has said is technically absolutely 100% correct, that the efficacy improves, but you have to weigh the pros and cons. I feel getting it after 6 to 8 weeks is a right balance of a choice than waiting till 12 weeks.
This is my personal Do you agree with that, Dr. Mahajan?
I agree entirely with that. You know, you asked the context, the question in the context of which is the best. The best is 3 months, but we have to see it in our context. And with a 40% positivity rate, we have to save ourselves. So the quicker, the better. I would say 6 weeks rather than even 8 weeks in the present circumstances.